In a letter to the office of the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights in Uganda, dated 3rd February, the Foreign Affairs Ministry said it will not renew the host country agreement it signed with the office of the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights, which established its initial mandate in the country in 2005. As the current mandate signed on 9th February 2020 expires in August, the opposition in parliament, led by its leader Mathias Mpoga, have come out to condemn the decision by government to close the office of the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights at the time when violation of human rights is on a rampage.
This impending closure of this office speaks to the intentions of the regime, and when Parliament resumes, we are going to demand for an explanation from the regime, because we believe that this decision was irrational and is going to affect our standing from among UN states, and to have ripple effects on a number of activities we do with other nations, including trade and other related relations.
Mpoga castigated government over the decision with concerns of its impact on Uganda's position in the United Nations. He accused the government of running away from scrutiny by chasing away the UN human rights organ.
And Sandra should take note that the regime is scared of scrutiny and they want to work in the dark. So every citizen should be on their high alert that nobody is safe in the face of the impending closure of this global policing entity on human rights. So regime, be aware, we are following you, we are watching you, we are watching your activities and intentions. They're not innocent, they're intended. Provide you a darker corner to continue the survival activities of torture, abduction, repression of opponents.
The opposition now wants the Minister of Foreign Affairs to appear before Parliament and explain why government chooses to work in the dark by closing this office, which has been vital in terms of overseeing government actions.
We demand that the Minister of Foreign Affairs will come to Parliament and explain whether he has created his own charter and our commitment. The Roman statute and other statutes has now been watered down in as far as respect for human rights is concerned.
Members of Parliament have also spoken out on the matter and expressed displeasure with government for kicking out this important organization from the country.
What is happening in the Uganda Human Rights Commission, every Ugandan is watching. So it is not surprising that the Office of Human Rights, the Office of United Nations on Human Rights is no more in this country. As we have been observing, several organizations are no more. DGF, who have been funding several organizations to monitor respect on human rights, are no more in this country. So, whatever it takes, as we Ugandans, as human rights activists in this country, we are still committed.
Still scrutinizing the statement issued by the government in suspending the declaration charter of human rights, and also in defiling the working relationship with the UN. We know that the Universal Declaration Charter under UN respects all human rights, and human rights are fundamentals, are godly given, they are given by nature, and Uganda is a member state which is bound to respect human rights. If it suspends the charter for respect of human rights, it implies it does no longer respect human rights. So we want, immediately as we come back from recess, we shall demand the government to explain the status quo and how it's going to handle matters of human rights.
It is barely 3 months since the UN's Committee Against Torture adopted the concluding observations on Uganda, which raised concern that torture and ill treatment continue to be frequently practiced, and called for investigation and prosecution of security officials accused of excessive use of force, violence, and arbitrary detention. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.